Supabase is a favorite choice of builders and developers everywhere because it makes it easy to build production-grade applications with a Postgres database, authentication, backend functions, and more. While Supabase Auth is simple to set up, once you go to production, you'll need a custom email provider, as you currently can only send 2 emails per hour through Supabase's default solution. In this video, we'll look at how to add Resend as a custom email provider in Supabase, as well as how to benefit from the added visibility a custom email provider gives you. You ready? Let's go. Here I have a sample project in Supabase. I've enabled Supabase Auth and can test the flow by inviting a new user. Because Supabase includes a built-in email provider, I'll receive a login code, but it comes from a mail.app.supabase.io address. While the flow works well, I don't have full visibility into email sending, deliverability, and metrics, and it's not branded with my branding. Plus, I can only send a few emails per hour once I move to production. So let's add Resend as a custom email provider. In order to send from my domain, I'll need to add it in Resend first. This process authorizes Resend to send on your behalf, and it only needs to happen once. In the Resend dashboard, select domains and then add a new domain. We typically recommend using a subdomain to separate off different types of sending. The benefit is that if one subdomain has deliverability issues, it's less likely to affect all the sending from your domain. In order to authorize Resend to send emails on your behalf, you'll need to add specific DNS records to your domain. Here, I'm using Cloudflare, which means I have a one-click installation to add all these domain records to my account. If you're using a provider that doesn't support this protocol, you can follow our documentation steps to add these records one at a time. Once these records propagate, Resend will update the status, showing that you can successfully send from your custom domain. Next, let's connect Supabase and Resend with the custom Supabase integration. Under Settings, select Integrations and click Connect to Supabase. You'll be prompted to log in to Supabase if you're not already authenticated, and then you'll need to authorize Resend for your organization. First, select a project from the dropdown. You'll need to create an API key for the integration, which will do for you if you select your desired domain and click Add API Key. Finally, confirm your email settings. We handle the basic settings, but you want to add a sender name and adjust the sender email if needed before clicking Configure SMTP Integration. It's that easy. We'll handle all the details for you. Go to your Supabase dashboard to confirm the integration and ensure that Enable Custom SMTP is toggled on. Ready to test it out? I've deleted my original user, so let's send the invite again. While the functionality remains the same, the email now comes from my custom domain. And I can also view the email in the Resend dashboard, which gives me visibility into the status of the email, provides key insights to help me improve deliverability, and more. There are several ways you can customize the experience. First, change the default email templates directly from within the Supabase dashboard. Under Emails, select the template you want to change. You can make basic changes to the plain text, or even add your own custom HTML. Just remember to add back in the custom variables if you need them for your email. You can even preview the new template or test the flow to see it in your own inbox. Second, you can customize the rate limits within Supabase. By default, Supabase currently allows for 25 emails per hour for custom SMTP configurations, but you can change that limit in your project's authentication settings. This is just the beginning for working with Supabase and Resend. You can also add Resend to Supabase Edge functions to send other types of transactional emails like contact form confirmations, waitlist signup emails, and more. If you're interested in a full Supabase Edge functions tutorial, let us know below. Thanks so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Happy sending.